When I started sharing Zoe's Corner with you in December, the subscribers were sitting, I think, at 41, and it has grown to 460, and I think it is not luck. We've created the correct videos that kids wanted to watch. And one of those videos, I want to show you a step-by-step quicker way of creating this video. But before we do that, I just want to say a shout out. They call it shout out. I just want to send out a shout out to Candy Melon. They've been following my channel. They have 323 subscribers and they wanted me to send a shout out. Well, go watch their videos. They're quite cool. They're creating kiddies videos and they're using some of the teachings from my channel. So thank you for watching me, Candy Melon. And yes, a big shout out to you. Let's get back to the video. With the video that I want to show you, it is one of the popular videos that I completely believe that it has grown this channel. When you select popular on Zoe's channel, you will see that Guess and Learn the Animal video has drawn like 36,000 views in 1 month. And this is because it is a game video and kids love that. You can go ahead and go create it the way that I've created it from scratch with blank canvases on Canva and edit, you know, the way that you want. The shortcut to that is using Canva's templates. So you're going to open up your Canva. If you don't have a Canva account, you're more than welcome to use my link in the description below and use the trial that is there for 30 days using all the elements that are available. If you do have Canva, then you can go ahead and open up your Canva and stick on your search contact and type Guess There. You can use either Guess the Animal or Guess the Fruit. So in this instance, we're going to be using a Guess the Animal template. And you're going to click on Canva's templates. There are a lot of these templates that are available. You must just know that most of them are for pro users. That's why if you're using my trial below, you can have access to these for 30 days. But when you do upgrade, then you're supporting my channel. So there's Guess the Farm Animals, there's Guess This, Guess Fruit, Guess the Game. So there's a lot of templates that you could use on Canva to do this. So step number one is to find a template. I found this Guess the Animal template that I want to use for our tutorial. You will then select it. And then you open and customize the template. And just the trick is, if you found a template, there are more like the one that you've picked that you could use for future games that you would like to use on your channel. So it's quite helpful. You're going to click and customize the template and then it opens up. So that's your step number one. Find a template that you like and then open it up and start customizing. The nice thing about template, it comes with animations, but you know, you can make it your own. That's why we call it customization. The first page looks like this. I want to tweak it and change it and add Zoe on here, which I did. And I want to show you the first page, how I tweaked mine. I tweaked it not a lot because my character is Zoe. I've added her when she was saying hello and
hey friends, let's play Guess the Animal. This is a multiple choice game with you choosing A, B, or C.
So now you're seeing something that's not on the template. That's the next step. The next step, you're going to go and record the instructions of how the game is played. And we move over to step number two. You will create your voices and using 11 Labs. So I love 11labs.io and I use it quite a lot. And at the moment, I haven't upgraded to the paid version of 11 Labs. I'm still using it as a free. So you are going to go find voices. And with the voices, you're going to scroll down and listen to the different voices and you pick the one that suits your character on your channel. So I use Gigi and she sounds like this.
Happiness can exist only in acceptance.
And this is the voice that I've used for my Zoe channel. So once you're happy, you're gonna click on use and then it will allow you to write your text so that it generates the speech for you. So based on the template that I've picked, I'm going to see what is it that I want the character to say to the people that are going to be playing the game. And then I start tweaking it. The way that I've made it, I've decided to leave the instructions, make this a little bit bigger, and then change the colors to what I want. And it looks like this. I just changed color, made it bullet points for the kids, for it to be simple. And then I made this a little bit bigger and I added an arrow. And then I've moved on to the next page. And I said, do you want to get ready? So 11 Labs allows you to create these voices and to create this animation the way that I use it. I type all of my text, all of it, not one by one, all of it at the same time. And then I move it over to Canva and break it up because I'm trying as much as possible to use up the free version of 11 Labs instead of me upgrading. So that's going to give you a little bit more work, but it's fine because once you have all of the text that you've typed it in and you've imported to Canva, you can then start editing the Canva and cutting the audio to suit the slide that you're currently at.
Fun fact.
Awesome. Then I'm going to add the fun fact so that it plays this way.
That's correct. It's a hamster. Fun fact. Hamsters stuff their cheeks with food like tiny grocery bags.
That's correct. Great. So that means the slide is smaller, then you increase the slide so that the fun fact gets fitted to the slide. And then it plays like this.
That's correct. It's a hamster. Fun fact. Hamsters stuff their cheeks with food like tiny grocery bags.
And then your slide is done. And then you're off to the next slide, which is the butterfly slide.
That's correct. It's a butterfly. That's correct. It's a butterfly.
Okay, so that means I'm going to move my correct when she says that's correct. And I'm going to go get the, what animal is this?
What animal is this?
And then I'm going to duplicate that. Take that track, move it to the butterfly.
What animal is this?
And then before she says that's correct, remove the that's correct. And the slide still has the hamster. Therefore, you delete the hamster. You make the butterfly bigger. If you're happy with this butterfly, you're more than welcome to go to elements and change it to something that suits you. And then we're going to hide the elements timing and then we play it.
What animal is this?
And then music is going to be playing, which we're going to add just now. Then?
That's correct. It's a butterfly.
Great stuff. Therefore, we adjust the answer is.
That's correct. It's a butterfly.
Something like that. So use your audio for your game so that it's fun. If you don't have access to Pro, you can always use freesound.org because freesound, you can search for different kinds of sounds and then you import them back to Canva so that you have your game all fun and games. And then now I'm going to add music that we've downloaded from Suno. If you've missed the Suno video, you can go watch it once you're done with this one to help you generate music from Suno. And then you add your music. You're going to go to your create and then create different kinds of music that you can use with your game. So I've created the Guess the Animal music and I've used a nursery rhyme, cheerful, toddler-friendly melody, slow beat, which is fun and it's quiz-like. That's the type of music it doesn't have. And then you can listen to all of them and decide whichever one you want to use. And once you make your choice and you download it, you're going to add it to your uploads. And then it's added. Then we add our music.
Hey friends, let's play Guess the Animal. This is a multiple choice game with you choosing A, B, or C.
So because we want Zoe to be audible, we're going to select the music and then adjust it and make it a little bit lower so that it plays at the background. But where there are gaps, we make it to be a little bit louder.
Hey friends, let's play Guess the Animal. This is a multiple choice game with you choosing A, B, or C. When you see the picture, shout A, B, or C. Are you ready? Let's go!
Because here, the slide doesn't have any audio. I would then split the audio and then split the audio so that this little gap that doesn't have any audio, I can increase and adjust my sound so that it's a little bit louder to get the engagement that I want.
What animal is this?
And then you would tweak it like that and adjust it as you go along. Then you split the audio until where the audio ends for when Zoe's talking or the character is talking, and then adjust your audio to loud and do that throughout the template.
Let's play Guess the Animal. This is a multiple choice game with you choosing A, B, or C. When you see the picture, shout A, B, or C. Are you ready? Let's go! What animal is this? That's correct, it's a hamster.
I think the only thing would be my sparkles. I haven't added them here, but otherwise, this is how you create these Guess the Games quicker instead of spending a lot of time wasted creating these with templates that are available on Canva. If something like this adds value to your life, please share, like, let me know on the comments. Tell me that this is adding value because it helps the channel. It helps the other animators out there who are trying to grow their channel. This video, the old McDonald farm video, is going to help you even further if you haven't watched it. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you with our next video.